A major concern for the military medical community is burn and blast injuries, like those a service member might sustain from an IED attack or similar. Injuries like those can quickly become infected if they aren't treated in a hospital quickly, which can be a big problem because troops aren't fighting right next to hospitals or medical facilities. Late last year, the RAND Corporation posted a study that showed one solution showing greater promise: sliver field dressings. Now, the technology is not new. It's been around for a couple of decades, but the study showed that the sliver appears to be proving effective. The reasons why the sliver works are not greatly understood, but we talked to one of the manufacturers of these kind of bandages to find out a little bit more about them and why they're a good tool in a combat medic's kit. Thanks for joining us, Raul.
Pleasure to be here.
So tell me a little bit about the history of the development of the Silverlon antimicrobial dressings.
Sure. So the technology has been around since the early 2000s and was originally designed with burn care and wound care in mind. Very early in our development process, we introduced the technology to the United States military by presenting it at Brooke Army Medical Center, or BAMC, down in San Antonio. And frankly, they engaged at a high level right from the get-go. Shortly after that, we were engaged in a conflict in the Middle East, and they deployed the technology in that environment, in that theater, and from that came back with lots of ideas and improvements, and then we, of course, pursued those improvements.
So, you know, what sort of differentiates a burn or a blast injury from, say, you know, a gunshot or a shrapnel wound, especially in sort of a battlefield environment?
Yeah, so I won't get too deep into the clinical piece because I don't want to pretend to be a clinician, but, you know, there are several things that threaten the patient's life when you suffer a significant burn. One of those, of course, is infection, one of the primary concerns of any burn surgeon or any individual who suffered a burn injury is to prevent infection. And that's where our technology comes into play, because we are a unique antimicrobial dressing that is used on these large burns.
So, you know, walk me through the process from sort of injury to essentially healing and the role that the silver nylon dressing can sort of play in that process.
When you sustain an injury, and I will tell you, the United States military faces some very unique challenges because they don't, you know, their injuries don't happen typically within miles of a healthcare facility that they have access to anyway. They often happen in extremely austere environments and in certain situations where they simply cannot get definitive care for a period of time, right? That's why the concept of prolonged field care is something that I think the entire DOD is incredibly focused on and interested in. And I think we play a role in that environment because we are able to get on that wound almost immediately after the injury has been sustained, and we provide an antimicrobial protection.
What is, you know, sort of the main, you know, what are some of the main differences between, you know, a typical hospital room, you know, dressing and what Silverlon is?
Okay, so you go back to the Civil War, right? You had cotton, gauze-like materials. Those were used quite frequently, you know, in hospitals all over the world until about a decade ago, and they're still used quite frequently even today. But in the last decade or 15 years, antimicrobial dressings have found a niche, found a place to help, you know, especially populations that are, you know, significantly immune compromised or have, you know, multiple comorbidities. Now, what most technologies try to do is take some hydrofiber, a foam, or even a gauze-like material and either coat it or impregnate it with some sort of antimicrobial agent. And that antimicrobial agent oftentimes gets kind of entrapped, right, inside of that that dressing. They haven't demonstrated a ton of, you know, clinical efficacy. What we did that was, frankly, incredibly different than most of the antimicrobial dressings out there is that we have plated a nylon substrate with pure metallic silver, or 99.9% pure metallic silver. And that gives us a couple of very unique features. One, we are able to put a ton of silver because we're circumferentially plating every fiber of that nylon with the silver, which is the antimicrobial agent. The other thing that we do is we have you hydrate our dressing with either sterile water or saline, and that causes a chemical reaction that releases in the dressing an enormous number of silver ions. And silver ions are what actually eradicate the bacteria, the virus, or the fungus. So that unique approach, not impregnating, but plating, and allowing us to put so much of the antimicrobial in the dressing has, I think, given us exceptional antimicrobial capabilities. And frankly, I think what has led to us being able to publish so much prospective, peer-reviewed, published data on the clinical efficacy of our device.
Silver dressings made by Silverlon are actually in a lot of medic kits in the military, and study on their efficacy is ongoing. It's one of the tools for military members we'll be looking at here at Military Times in coming weeks. So stay tuned for more developments on items service members may be using every day.